it's Michelle again, and for the next couple of weeks, we're going to be talking about lithics. And lithic artifacts are artifacts that are made of stone. And there's a whole variety of different types that you can find, but the big ones that people usually think about are flaked or chipped lithics, and those have been flint-napped, so pieces broken off to form a tool. And usually people think of arrowheads when they think of those things. But a lot of things that people call arrowheads, and we'll talk more about this, but they're often too big to actually work on an arrow. So they're probably either spear points or knives, but there definitely are some little chipped lithics that were used in arrows. And then we've also got chipped lithics that were used for gardening tools and farming implements, woodworking tools. And then we also have other classes of lithic artifacts as well. We have ground tools. So those might be shaped by pounding something and then sanded down really nicely to form a pretty sharp point or pointed edge, sharp edge. And then we also find unmodified things. So the pieces that are broken off of a flake tool, sometimes those are worked more and then we can tell more about them. But other times it's just a broken piece of rock and it's not really modified beyond that. And then other times we find another thing called firecracked rock. And that's when there was rock. Maybe it was worked or flaked beforehand, but it might have just been a piece of rock and it was subjected to a fire, whether purposefully or when someone's house burned down. And then we can see how that rock changes and breaks when it's exposed to fire. And we're going to talk about all of those different aspects of lithics as the weeks go on. But for right now, we have a really nice exhibit at our state park, at Perkins Archaeological State Park, that our park interpreters put together. And so I'm gonna share some pictures that I took of that exhibit that have really good explanations of how chipped lithic stone tools are made and shows the stages of napping a stone tool. And then it'll show you some points that run through time. And I think that it's a really good way to start out. It gives you a little bit of vocabulary about lithics, and it really gives you a good idea of starting with a rock. How do you end up with a tiny little arrow point like this? So I'm going to share that right here with this post. And then next week, we'll talk more about some different artifact types specifically that we find in and around Perkin. So I will talk to you later, enjoy the pictures, and come in and see our actual exhibit at Perkin Archaeological State Park. We have much more than that exhibit in the museum, but this one is particularly good. All right, talk to you next week.